Bula Fiji, welcome to Jejemon. Namaste to you and good evening. I hope you're having a great evening from whatever part of our beautiful country you're joining me from. Tonight, a bula vinaka to our viewers in the province of Mba Town and surrounding areas. Thank you for your company tonight. This week, it's our special coverage of the inaugural 2019 National Designer Awards organized by the Fashion Council of Fiji that was held at the Grand Pacific Hotel right here in the capital, Suva. There were four major awards up for grabs: Designer, Future Designer, Model and Fashion Media of the Year, and we begin our coverage from the guest arrivals. Let's check out what some of the guests wore to the awards evening.
3, 2, and rolling.
These days my waves get lost in the ocean. 7 billion swimmers, man, I'm going through the motions. Sent up a flare, I need love and devotion. Traded for some faces that I'll never know, notion. Maybe I should try to find the old me. Take me to the places and the people that know me. Trying to just connect, thinking maybe you could show me. There's so many people here, then why am I so lonely?
One of Fiji's top fashion designers. In actual fact, he's been nominated tonight for the prestigious Designer of the Year, Mr. Isaiah Kanrote. Welcome to the show, Isaiah.
Thank you, Andy, and your team, Bula Vinaka.
Bula, now, first of all, tell me about your outfit. What are you wearing tonight? I'm guessing that this is something that you would have created yourself.
That's true. Yeah, every piece I have, I created myself. But however, the assembly of it, I had my 9-year granddaughter put it together for me.
Mm. You have a very talented granddaughter, by the way. I do, yeah.
Mm.
On the belt, and then you have all the tapa prints on the shirt. Like,
yes.
Well done.
Thank you. I think tonight the theme is neon.
Right.
If you know, we always wanted to be different, so I thought, since everyone's going to come neon, I'll come island inspired.
Right. And I think you look great. Now,
thank you.
How long did it take you to get ready tonight?
We had an event at home, a family function, so I was there, but everything was ironed and ready, so getting ready, having a shower and all that, within, say, 45 minutes.
And no makeup, no bronzer, nothing?
Nothing. not even eyeliner.
You're going natural.
Yeah, absolutely.
Now, you were nominated tonight for the Designer of the Year. How are you feeling about this award?
Oh, man, feeling blessed and exhilarating. I'm happy, and I'm just happy to attend. I think for me, this is the closest I can get to attending an Oscar Awards, but that is also in the pipeline.
Fantastic. Well, we wish you the very best of luck.
Thank you very much.
We hope to see you grab the main award this evening.
Yes, it's either me or the other 10 nominees. I think we have a good bunch, and that is a celebration of us, our work for us in Fiji, and hoping inspiring enough for the upcoming designers, regardless of age, creed, or whatever.
Now, if you watched Style Fiji, our delayed coverage on Boxing Day last year, you would have been familiar with Jane Whiteside. Now, she is a Fijian designer that's based in China and is nominated for the National Designer Award, the prestigious award tonight. But unfortunately, she won't be here, so she's being represented by her beautiful mom, Jasmine Tam. Welcome to the show, Jasmine.
Thank you, Andy.
Now, first of all, I'm sure you must be feeling very proud of all the achievements that Jane has accomplished over the years that she's been designing. How are you feeling tonight?
Oh, I'm feeling actually quite nervous and quite thrilled for her, and actually quite humbled.
And have you spoken to her at all this week before coming to this awards? Like, has she like given any feedback on how she is feeling being nominated for the prestigious award?
Yes. She's actually really proud to be nominated, and to be nominated against her fellow nominees. I mean, that is such an achievement for her. She's hopeful, but not confident that she has a chance, because I mean the others are really great in everything that they do, and she's so happy for them and so happy for Fiji designers as a whole.
Now, for those of our viewers that are watching on FBC TV, tell us about your outfit tonight. I already know who designed this, so you can tell everyone that is not familiar with it, like, what are you wearing tonight?
Okay, this is one of Jadeen's creations. It's her Tapa Rose collection that she launched at Fiji Fashion Festival this year. And this outfit, actually, she made for the royal visit that we had earlier this year, and which I was very happy to wear for her.
Well, I think you look absolutely beautiful. And once again, congratulations to Jadeen, and fingers crossed that she comes out on top tonight.
Thank you very much.
Now, if you ever visit Nausori Town in my beautiful province of Thailand, I might add,
of
and you're
course.
Going to the ANZ Bank, This is the guy that you need to see, the friendly face of Timothy Lala. Good evening, Tim, and welcome
Hi.
To the show.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Andy.
Now, first of all, I must say, when you got out of the car this evening, yeah. I just got drawn by what you're wearing tonight. Like, tell me, like, what are you wearing? Who designed your garment and how long did it take you to get ready?
Oh, man, Andy, this is a beautiful garment done by my mom. She sewed it. Her name is Amelia, and she's really good with sewing and putting out a display. So I just thought of wearing it out tonight.
Well, you look great. Is this something that you planned that you were going to wear to the awards tonight, or did you just have a look at it today and then decide that you're going to wear it?
Well, she did it for me a month ago on my birthday, on Christmas Eve, and so I thought of just having a recap on it tonight.
Now, I was looking at the tables earlier inside the video, I saw the A and Z table.
That's right.
What are you hoping to take away from this inaugural designer awards tonight? Like, once it's all finished, like, what are you hoping to take away from this?
Thank you, Andy. I'd like to I'm just glad to be here. You know, I'm just overwhelmed, and things around me are just so nice and beautiful. People around me are so nice, and everybody's just feeling the love right here tonight. So I'd like to share that. And tonight, I just like to take back my give back to my employer, ANZ, and say thank you to them, because this is mainly for them. Thanks a lot, Andy.
Well, I think you look amazing, and a great night, and I hope to see you dancing on the DJ booth later on.
Yes, I sure will have a good night tonight. Thank you very much, Andy.
With me is a nominee for Designer of the Year, as well as Fashion Media of the Year, Electric Rayono of the Grand Azulia. Welcome to the show.
Thank you, Andy.
Now, first of all, we'll talk about your art. What are you wearing today? I'm guessing that you probably wear a piece. Are you wearing a piece that you might have created?
Yes, I'm wearing one of my own shirts, and I just wore neon underneath, so sticking to the theme tonight. Yeah, I'm excited.
And how long did it take you to get ready this evening?
Maybe 20 minutes. Yeah, I already planned it ahead, so I knew it was going to take a while to put the outfit together. I just thought, I have to represent the brand, and so I'm excited to be wearing it tonight.
Great. Now,
thank you.
This is the first year that the Designer Awards is taking
Yes.
place, and you're nominated for two awards. Is there any pressure that you're feeling tonight? Like,
No pressure at all. I know I'm amongst some of the greatest designers in Fiji, so I'm just honored to be part of the awards and be part of one of the first National Designers Awards. Yeah, so it's exciting to be nominated with some of the greatest designers in Fiji.
Meet someone that is no stranger to the limelight and also the fashion industry here in Fiji. In fact, he's the chairman of the Fashion Council of Fiji, as well as the founder of the Bottega Gold Fijian Fashion Festival. My good friend Faz, or known to many as Faraz Ali, welcome to the show, Faraz.
Hi, lovely. Thank you for having me.
Now, first of all, I can't help but notice your coat of many colors. Now, tell us about your outfit. What are you wearing tonight?
Well, tonight I needed to be unbiased as a chairperson of the council. Ordinarily, I would wear a designer, but because tonight so many of our wonderful designers are on show, I'm actually not wearing a Fijian designer. That's primarily just because I didn't want to show any sort of favoritism or bias towards anybody who's nominated tonight. As most of the people who are nominated tonight, all the people nominated, are some of our best designers, and I very often wear their clothes.
Now, this is the inaugural awards. How important is this awards to you? I know that this has been sort of like your brainchild for a long time, and now it's here. The evening has finally arrived for the National Design Awards. How important is this evening to you?
It's very important. I think that it's very important to me personally, and it's very important also to the industry at large, because it's the first time in Fiji and the Pacific's history that we're having an awards show to celebrate fashion business. So in the past we had shows like, you know, the Fiji Red Cross and Project 91, which were amazing shows, and also, you know, various other awards along the way through other shows, but they celebrated sort of, you know, a particular runway presentation. What we've assessed over the year, the whole year, is the designer's business performance and also their product development, their merchandising, their social media, the way they've engaged with their market. So it's really significant because it's like an announcement to Fiji and the world that we are ready to take on bigger pursuits now. We're ready to take on the next level of our growth, you know. We are artists, yes, but we are also business people. So it is very exciting and it's very important.
Mm. Now, you were in Sydney recently. You attended a Christian Dior event.
Yes.
Can you tell us about that? I followed your stories on Instagram, and I mean, I was just blown away by this because Dior is a renowned international designer. Tell us about how you got invited to this event and what was the event like?
Essentially, you know, I mean, in the work that I do, and because I lived in Sydney for some time as well, there are various contacts that that I have there, people who work in media. Arnold Olsen, who is a Fijian but lives in Sydney now, has a very popular, very well-followed online magazine called Rogue On. He has about 100,000 followers on Instagram and various other things, and he's very well-respected. So the launch essentially was the Dior Men, or the Dior Kim Jones launch. It was very exciting, of course. It's a wonderful event. I think that for me, it sets a benchmark for what we can also achieve here. So I'm always sort of attending these sorts of events to, of course, make better connections for us in Fiji, but also to look at how our events can be stronger and how events can be more global. And so tonight, what we're presenting is a truly global event.
Now let's talk about forecast for the Designer Awards. What is your vision for the awards in the years to come?
You know, we're starting small. We're starting with, I think, 5 primary awards it is, and then we have a special award tonight as well. But we would like to grow the categories over time. As our industry grows and we have better segmentation, eventually what I would like to see is that we have a Textile Design of the Year award. They're celebrating textile design excellence because, you know, many people are working with print. I'd like to have an Ethical Producer of the Year award. I would like to, you know, there's various things that we can sort of branch into. But this year, I just felt it was very important that we just take the first step, because otherwise, we would keep waiting.
Slowly but surely.
Slowly but surely.
I love your visions, and once again, congratulations. I had a look at the venue earlier on, and I'm just blown away by the setup. It's very international, and kudos to you and your team.
Thank you. My team is wonderful, and you know, none of this is possible without the team, and I think that's very important to acknowledge. Sidel, Georgia, Dylan, Hanisi, Eli, Philippa as well, you know, these are the people who really pull it together. My job is to sell it. But
your job is to just stand and be the pretty face.
And be pretty, because I'm the model.
Right, of course. Of course you are. And once again, congratulations for us, and enjoy the rest of the evening. Now, it's a rainy night here in Suva, and right here at the Grand Pacific Hotel, the 2019 National Design Awards, and we're graced by the very beautiful Ellen Whippy Knight of Fiji Fashion Week. Welcome to the show, Ellen.
Thank you very much, Andy. Really nice to be here on this rainy night, but it's a special occasion, so, you know, the weather doesn't matter.
Now, you look amazing. Now, first of all, tell me about your outfit. What are you wearing?
Thank you. Since it's the National Designer Awards, I thought I should wear a locally designed dress, and this is Hefrani by Isaiah Conrote, who is actually one of the longest designers in terms of his participation in the fashion industry, including Fiji Fashion Week. And he's also up for a nomination tonight for Designer of the Year Award. So good luck, Isaiah.
Now, I know that Fiji Fashion Week is coming up. Like, can you give us any insights into what to expect from this year's
Yes, of course. We are being held at the FMF Gym on the 20th to the 25th of May. 2019, of course, and as usual, you know, every year fashion weeks develop and their themes change according to what's happening on the political scene, what's happening in life in general. This year it's urban jungle, and the urban jungle is a reflection of the sustainability issue in fashion and how fashion is really one of the biggest polluters of the environment, which is an unfortunate thing. But how it also contributes to climate change, and our little contribution this year will be to use recycled and natural products in our actual setup of the show.
Sounds very exciting. I look forward to attending this year. Now, the awards tonight, what are you hoping to take away from the awards tonight?
Look, I think the National Design Awards is an absolute necessity in the industry to reward those who work very, very hard. And reward them for the time and effort. The actual Fashion Council had one in 2011. It was called the Crystal Ball. And I think when you look back at the first one we had, it really shows how these designers have actually developed because of the platform that they have now. And I mean, for tonight, I would like the audience out there, people who love fashion, to be able to see that there is a platform there for them, and that you can be rewarded, or will be rewarded, for your hard work.
Thank you so much, Ellen. You look amazing.
Thank
now
you.
Enjoy the rest of your night, and I
will indeed
see you doing a bit of table dancing later on.
Oh, well, I'm not quite sure about that at the moment, but I'm sure I'll put in something. Okay, thank you.
Fashion from the guest arrivals at the inaugural National Designer Awards that was held at the Grand Pacific Hotel here in the capital, Suva. The evening was a great night of fashion, honoring the works of our hardworking fashion industry. Time for a short break, more from the awards. After the break, we find out who won what. That's next. See you soon.